Appendicitis is an infection of the appendix. Anyone who has an appendix can develop appendicitis, including children. Hi, I'm Dr. Beth, and I'm a pediatrician at SickKids. Let's talk about appendicitis and five important things for you to know. One, what is the appendix and what is appendicitis? The appendix is a small tube-like structure attached to our intestines or bowels. It is connected to the part called the cecum and is usually located in the lower right side of the belly. Did you know that the appendix actually has no known function in the body? When the appendix gets infected, this is called appendicitis. Sometimes bacteria or viruses can cause appendicitis, or sometimes the appendix becomes blocked by poop, and this can also lead to appendicitis. When the appendix gets infected, it can become swollen and painful. We don't know why some people get appendicitis and others don't. Anyone at any age with an appendix can develop appendicitis. Two, signs and symptoms of appendicitis. If your child has appendicitis, they may feel pain around their belly button or the lower right side of their belly. This pain may feel worse when you press on your child's belly, when they move, or when they breathe deeply. Your child may also not want to eat, feel nauseous, vomit, and have a fever. Three, diagnosis of appendicitis. Appendicitis is sometimes difficult to tell apart from other causes of belly pain in children, such as constipation or a stomach virus. A healthcare provider can ask questions and examine your child to help identify the source of their pain. They may order blood and urine tests to look for signs of infection and to rule out other causes of belly pain. If the healthcare provider suspects appendicitis, your child may also have either an ultrasound or CT scan to confirm the diagnosis. Four, treatment of appendicitis. If your child is diagnosed with appendicitis, then they will need surgery to remove their appendix. This surgery is called an appendectomy. It can often be done using several very small incisions called keyhole incisions. Antibiotics will also be given to your child. Most children with appendicitis go back to their normal activities within a week or two after the surgery. Because there is no known function for the appendix, children who have an appendectomy should have no long-term effects from the surgery. If your child's appendix has ruptured or burst, a more severe infection can develop called an abscess. This infection cannot be treated by appendectomy alone. If your child has an abscess from a ruptured appendix, they will need a longer course of antibiotics. Sometimes the infection needs to be treated first before the appendix can be removed. In those situations, the appendectomy may be scheduled later after the infection is fully treated. Children who have a burst appendix may also be sicker with more fever, pain, and vomiting, and may need to stay in hospital longer until they are feeling better. Five, how you can help your child after appendectomy. When your child goes home from the hospital, follow the instructions given to you by the surgical team. Your child's incisions will be covered by a dressing called Steri-Strips. The Steri-Strips will fall off on their own, but if they haven't fallen off 7 to 10 days after your child's surgery, then you can remove them. Make sure you wash your hands before touching or cleaning your child's incisions. You can give your child acetaminophen after surgery to manage any pain your child is feeling. Follow the instructions on the bottle to know how much to give them. After surgery, your child can go back to eating their regular diet, and your child can go back to their regular activities once they feel able to do so. Most children go back to their normal activities within a week or two. I hope you found this video helpful. Subscribe and visit aboutkidshealth.ca for more. Thanks for watching. Stay healthy, everyone.